Emily.
We're looking for Oliver again.
The Missing is a thrilling narrative puzzle. They tantalise us with clues in the past or in the present, and they shut the door on them, and we're desperate to find out more.
The start of the story, a husband and a wife and their young child are holidaying in France, and during this, an event takes place, and their son goes missing.
Tony, for one second, has been holding Oliver's hand, and the next minute he knows he's not holding his hand. From that point on, it becomes a nightmare.
It's compounded by the fact that they're having to go through the experience in a country they're not familiar with.
8 years later, he returns to the same town looking for a new clue that he thinks may tell him where his son was taken.
It's time to leave the past where it belongs.
Tony has not given up. He becomes reunited with the original detective. They become this sort of two outsiders in 2014 trying to kind of put together what happened to the child in 2006.
You, I think, like me, you've the need for an obsession.
We follow them as Tony becomes determined and more obsessed and more driven by trying to find out what happened to his son.
I found something.
He feels guilty. He feels it was his fault. That obsession to try and redeem himself and everything in his life.
I don't need you. I don't need them. I'll finish this myself.
One of the great tragedies about all his disappearance is what happened to Emily and Tony.
That night when we lost Ollie, I lost you too.
The Missing is ultimately a thriller in broad daylight. And it's all that more nightmarish for it because it happens in a world that we're all familiar with.
I've lost everything and everyone I ever cared for. This is all I have left.
It's about loss and hope. The very worst we can do, the very worst that can happen to us. But also it's about love and the sadness when love is taken.
I won't give up, no matter what.